Hello everyone, my name is Funny. Welcome to Funny Tech Updates. So friends, first of all, I wish you very happy and safe Diwali to all of you, and hope this Diwali will brings all happiness, strength and more wealth to all of us. So friends, today I'll share my knowledge about artificial intelligence in this video. So friends, let's not waste the time, let's get into the video. So, first of all, what is artificial intelligence and how it came into existence? So, artificial intelligence is nothing but it's an area of computer science which emphasizes the creation of intelligent machines that work and react like humans. And who is the founder of this artificial intelligence? John McCarthy is the founder of this artificial intelligence. We can say he is the father of this artificial intelligence. And we have some more members who helped him in creating the artificial intelligence. John McCarthy worked together with Marvin Allen and Simon to create this artificial intelligence. John McCarthy has kept the name artificial intelligence for a machine language program in 1955. So this artificial intelligence was started in 1955. But why it took so much time to came into existence in real world? So now I will tell you why it took so much time and what is the main purpose of this artificial intelligence. Although it was started in 1955, it took nearly 50 to 60 years to came into existence in real world. Previously, this artificial intelligence is used to detect the computer programming languages into a simple unification algorithm. And when it comes to programming languages, Python is considered to be the first preferred language to develop artificial intelligence due to the simplicity of program. And there are some major programming languages which are used to develop this artificial intelligence. And Java, C++ and LISP are the major programs which nowadays people are using to develop this artificial intelligence. Yes, AI was started in 1955, but it took so much time because lack of awareness. In 1955, people don't know anything about smartness and smart devices. So when smartphones and smart devices came into existence, this technology boomed up with a great impact. So we can say the artificial intelligence growth started with smart devices. Here I just want to tell one example. We use biometric for Aadhaar card enrollments. With the fingerprints, we don't know actually how secure it is, but we actually got to know when we are using it for our mobiles. So this is how the smartphones are impacting the humans' brains. So the developers of artificial intelligence thought to give this awareness to all the people by implementing this artificial intelligence into the smartphones. And from then, the smartphone companies started building their special hardware and special softwares for artificial intelligence. Most of the AI features appear to be centered around imaging, photography, power efficiency and security purpose. So we can say the future of the smart devices and smartphones are rooted in advancement of artificial intelligence with machine learning. Okay, now we know people are using artificial intelligence in smartphones and smart devices, but how it really works? Artificial intelligence works on the data which was provided by you. Let's take an example of smartphone. Now we are able to see personal assistance as never before. How it is suggesting you what you wanted to do next? Artificial intelligence understands your interests, emotions, moods, and even your prioritizing notifications in smartphones. So how it is collecting all the data? When you download an application in your smartphone, you're agreeing to allow that software to use all your data. So that AI can analyze your data within the phone with your controls. So within a few years, we can see AI will turn the smartphones into intelligent phones. So many smartphones released in this year are focused with artificial intelligence hardware and software. Nowadays, technology is growing as smart to super smart. When it comes to artificial intelligence is like a human brain. It's a network of signals, sensor and processing algorithms. It can digest a massive data based on your usual habits, daily patterns and past behavior. We can consider Google Home as the best example for this artificial intelligence in smart device. How banks are using this artificial intelligence as a tool for transformations? Banks are using artificial intelligence to provide the best advanced services like chatbots, robo-advisors and personal assistants based on your interest. Artificial intelligence can also detect the real-time frauds, insightful trading and AML checks. So this is how artificial intelligence is used by banks. And there are some cases where artificial intelligence can also be used in testing field. Basically, we can use artificial intelligence in automation testing. AI should be able to see not only the snapshot of document object model of the page, but also the visual picture of it as well. AI can write the test cases for you based on requirements, and it can also show the differences what it find in present application based on your previous version of the application. This AI technology can assist you in writing test code, and it can also pass the test cases. But when it fails, AI will notify you as a change. You can see whether it is a good change or it's a bad change based on your requirement. If you want to accept, you can accept it or you can reject it, that it will be a bug. So now we'll see the benefits of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence focuses on real-time data and it works smarter, faster and easiest way. It also improves accuracy. And artificial intelligence gives more number of ways to solve a problem which a human being cannot give some time. And it also reduces the manpower. Guys, if you are interested, there is an interview of artificial intelligence robot Sophia. So I'll provide the link in the description. You can go through that link and watch the interview of artificial intelligence robot. So that's all for today, friends. If you like this video, please hit like button. And if you are visiting first time to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned to my channel for latest tech updates. This is Fandi Kumar signing off.